Reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 4, Chapter 6, Text 40. Saha tu agatam atmayonim satu palabhyagatam atmayonim. Sura asura ishaihi abhivandita angrihi surasureshai abhivandita angrihi uthaya chakre irasa अभिवंदनम् उत्ताय चक्रे सुरसाभिवंदनम् अरहत्तमः कस्य यथा एव विष्णुः अरहत्तमा कस्य यतैव विष्णु सतूपलभ्यागतमात्मयोनिम् सुरासुरेशेरभिवन्दिताङ्गृहि उत्थाय चक्रे शिरसाभिवन्दनम् अर्हत्तमाकस्य यतैव विष्णु सतूपलभ्यागतमात्मयोनिम् सुरासुरेशैरभिवन्दिताङ्गृहि उत्थाय चक्रे शिरसाभिवन्दनम् अर्हत्तमकस्य यतैव विष्णुः. सः लॉर्ड शिवा तु बट उपलभ्य सीइंग आगतम हैड अराइव्ड आत्मयोनिम लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा सुरासुरैशैहि बाय द बेस्ट ऑफ द डेमिगॉड्स एंड डीमन अभिवंदिता अंग्रिहि हूज फीट आर वर्शिप्ड उत्थाय स्टैंडिंग अप चक्रे मेड शिरसा विथ हिज हेड अभिवंदनम रेस्पेक्टफुल अर्हत्तमः वामनदेवा कस्य ऑफ कश्यप यथा एव जस्ट एज विष्णुः विष्णु. ट्रांसलेशन परपोर्ट बाय डिवाइन ग्रेस अभय चरणारविंद भक्ति विदान स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद. ट्रांसलेशन लॉर्ड शिवाज लोटस फीट वे वर्शिप बाय बोथ द डेमिगॉड्स एंड द डीमंस बट स्टिल इन स्पाइट ऑफ हिज एग्जाल्टेड पोजिशन एज सून एज ही सॉ लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा वॉज देयर अमंग ऑल द अदर डेमिगॉड्स ही इमीडिएटली स्टूड अप एंड ऑफर्ड हिज रेस्पेक्ट बाय बोइंग डाउन एंड टचिंग हिज लोटस फीट. Just as Vamanadeva offered his respectful obeisances to Kashyapa Muni. Purport. Kashyapa Muni was in the category of the living entities, but he had a transcendental son, Vamanadeva, who was an incarnation of Vishnu. Thus, although Lord Vishnu is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he offered his respects to Kashyapa Muni, Similarly, when Lord Krishna was a child, he used to offer his respectful obeisances to his mother and father, Nanda and Yashoda. Also at the Battle of Kurukshetra, Lord Krishna touched the feet of Maharaj Yudhishthira because the king was his elder. It appears then that the personality of Godhead, Lord Shiva and other devotees, in spite of their being situated in exalted positions, instructed by practical example how to offer obeisances to their superiors. Lord Shiva offered his respectful obeisances to Brahma because Brahma was his father, just as Kashyapa Muni was the father of Vamana. So Brahma and all the demigods arriving to see Shiva, they all have a purpose to achieve, because there has been a lot of trouble created by Shiva, of course, originating from Daksha. Daksha's improper behavior, on a misunderstanding of Shiva's improper behavior, because of which Sati had to give up her body. Naturally, husband is not going to keep quiet. So after that Kalaha, worldly order has to come. Every time there is a mess in the world, order has to come. And for that, either Brahma has to go or Vishnu has to go. So here Brahma goes. Brahma and all the demigods. So now we see the etiquette followed by Shiva. Lot of small but very serious gestures which people have to follow in the material world. In the background of the aspect that Sarvam Kalvitam Brahman. Even though everything is Brahman, you have to follow certain things. You cannot say, why should I offer respect? Everything is Brahman. Why should I do this way? Why should I do that way? Why this rule? Who made this rule? Why can't we change the rule? All these questions people in Tamoguna have. Because people in Tamoguna do not follow any rules. Or in Rajoguna, because they have their own purposes to achieve. But rules are there. So it's a set principle in this material world by tradition. Some things are said by the Shastras directly. Bhagavatam shows so many etiquettes. Puranas, Itihasas, all these things show a lot of etiquettes followed by different kinds of people and having different kinds of relationship. So that is part of this world. Interaction between people in this material world, interaction between spirit and matter, interaction between living entities and living entities who are in the material body, where rules have to be followed, because you are dealing with people's mind, people's expectations, people's position, tradition, give and take. Who gives to whom? Who takes from whom? Principles are set by this basic principle. Because we are coming empty-handed, we are coming helpless. When you come helpless, many people help you. When those people help you, naturally there is a liability bondage. When a man takes birth, he is already liable to so many people. You get liable to the government later on. You get liable to the banks later on when you take loans. But when you come to the materialism, you already taken loan. When you take loan, you have to repay it. Rinas. Rishi Rina, Kula Rina. So many kind of Rinas. Liabilities we have to follow. We have to give back. So many things are there in the tradition. So here we see Shiva sitting. In the previous verses we saw he was not sitting simply without no work. He was sitting, he was discussing with great people like Narada. So many people are there. He is sitting in an argumentative mood. Probably they were talking philosophy. And philosophy always tarka comes. Because everybody has their opinion on philosophy. So he immediately got up. Why he didn't get up when he saw Daksha then? All problems would have been solved. So much of mess. Just get up. Just stand up if Daksha was coming. Why he didn't do that? So how do you set principles? How do you set standards? People can say, Shiva did not get up, so I don't have to get up when my father-in-law comes. So we can do all these things. That is why Yudhishthira says, dharma apratishtaha, tarko apratishtaha. By logic, you cannot. Mahajanena gatha sapantha, you have to follow the Mahajanas. Rules followed by the Mahajanas. And Shiva happens to be Mahajana. And this Mahajana is doing one thing one time and another thing another time. How do you follow that? So what is the set principle in this material world? Very difficult to understand. So we cannot say nothing is mentioned about this, so I don't have to follow. In a country, a constitution is there. You follow by the constitution. Everything is written in the constitution. What you do, who does, who goes, who comes, who has a first right, who has a second right. With all protocols are all there. But in spiritual life, then what is the protocol? It keeps changing sometimes. Desha, kala, patra. It's very dynamic. It's a very dynamic constitution. Sometimes constitutions are evolved. But the final constitution is never to forget Krishna, always remember Krishna. Right? That becomes the set principle. Shiva was remembering the Supreme Lord and sitting in meditation. Everybody waiting. Daksha walks in. He may not have seen Daksha. Daksha got angry. So what Daksha should have done? Daksha should also meditate on the Supreme Lord. My son-in-law is not showing respect. Okay, Krishna. So if everybody follows this rule, then there is no problem. So since everybody are not Krishna conscious, then these rules and regulations are a must. Why? Because evolution of the soul, evolution of one's consciousness happens in a collective way. Not individually. I'm alone in this world and I evolve and then become Krishna conscious. No, it doesn't happen. Our evolution happens in Sangha. By mutual respect, mutual blessings, mutual mercy. And that is why there are etiquettes. You have to get mercy of certain people if you have to go to the next level. You have to show mercy to some people if you have to be responsible for what you have learned. By teaching others, you solve or you settle your liability to a spiritual master who taught you. That is why we teach. We don't teach because to show that you are a great teacher. You teach to give your interest. This is an interest you give to your spiritual master. Right? So when we learn, then I have to pay back. How do I pay back? I pay back by teaching. So these interactions are there in this material world. And when you teach as obligated by the spiritual master, then you get the mercy of the spiritual master. It is not a show off thing, teaching, preaching. By preaching, we are obligated to Prabhupada to preach. Hence I am preaching. Not that I have learned so many sastras and so many songs and so many slokas. I get some cheap adoration from people. Did you get adoration from Prabhupada? Did you get blessings of Prabhupada? That becomes the principle. So when a person acts as duty bound in this way, then he is following the right etiquette. Etiquettes are based on that. It evolves. Due to social interactions, it has evolved. So these set principles have to be followed. And somebody is saying that, why should I show respect? Right here Prabhupada says. Lord Krishna showed respect. Lord Vamanadeva showed respect. Vamanadeva, Krishna, the Supreme Lord, they are not even Jiva Tattva. Kashyapa, Nandamara, they are all Jiva Tattva. So why would the Supreme Lord pay obeisances, take the shoes are the father, do menial service. There is an existence beyond rules and regulations. That is the existence of love. Before you reach that existence of love, you have to exist in the existence of rules and regulations. Vaidhi bhakti. You don't jump into raganuga bhakti. So there is no question of getting through the different levels of spiritual growth without following rules and regulations. If anybody is thinking that I will follow my rules and regulations, it's not possible. And that is why 18th chapter of Bhagavad Gita is there. After hearing everything, or 17th chapter, after everything, Arjuna is asking, what happens to those people who do sacrifices and so many things on their own mental platform without rules and regulations, Shastra? Krishna ends by saying it's of no use. Right? Faith develops by the association of the three modes of material nature. And you have to evolve from tamasic faith to rajasic faith to sattvic faith to Vishuddha Sattva faith. Right? Sattvam Vishuddham Vasudeva Sabditam. You have to go beyond and reach that platform. So our faith in the Supreme Lord, forget Supreme Lord, our faith in Brahman, that is spirit. Our faith that there are things, existence beyond the material body, has to evolve. And that can evolve only if you use the different assigned platforms of existence in this material world. Sattva-guna. In Sattva-guna, it generates faith in Brahman. Sattvam tat brahma darshanam. In Rajas, it creates another kind of faith. But it's better than tamoguna. So this faith in Brahman, in things beyond the body, is generated. And naturally when you talk about modes of material nature, social etiquettes, social interaction, everything comes. So there is a sattvic etiquette to be followed, there is a rajasic etiquette to be followed, there are tamasic etiquette you could follow. You could choose what you want to follow. You can talk to somebody in a rajasic way, tamasic way, sattvic way. You do sattvic way, you get one more plus point. You do tamasic way, you go minus. Well, this is a set rule of the material world. All the material things are working through some law of nature. This is law of spirit. Body follows law of nature. Spirit follows law of spirit. Now you are mixed in these two. So I have to follow some things according to law of nature. I can't jump off a building. I won't fly. I'll fall down. I am spirit. Fly. No, you won't fly. But if you got out of this body, then you can fly back to Krishna. Then your everything governing you is nature of spirit. So as long as you are in this material world, we have to follow these rules and regulations and etiquettes, which is very clearly mentioned. Otherwise, we don't evolve. And human being, Aryan, means he is always evolving. Aryan means one who evolves, one who's evolving in his culture of existence. Whether it's Varnashrama or whether it's Krishna consciousness, evolution should there evolve. We have to evolve on a day-to-day basis, otherwise it doesn't happen. So where does all this thing come? That's why Krishna says you have to follow 17th chapter, 14th verse. The austerity of the body consists in this worship of the Supreme Lord, the Brahmanas, the spiritual master, and the superiors like father and mother. You have to follow. Cleanliness, simplicity, celibacy, non-violence are all austerities of the body. If you don't follow the austerities of the body, then you don't evolve in the spirit. If you don't follow the austerities of work, the different way work is conducted. So all these things have its rules and regulations. Otherwise, we don't evolve. Finally, evolution is important. I need to get out of this body, but I have to follow this now. Without following this, you can't get out of the body. Vamana Deva, following the rules. Right? So when William Maharaj asked him, you just need 3 feet. Yeah. He gives a big lecture. What is the use of anything more than 3 feet? Even if you get the whole planet, and if you're not satisfied with self-satisfaction, what is the use? No use. So finally, one has to be satisfied. And satisfaction comes only with being satisfied with what you have. Or happiness comes with only what you have. If you're satisfied with what you have. Otherwise, happiness doesn't come. And the aim of life is what? Happiness. So I'm happy with 3 feet. Great kings, Maharaj Prithu, Maharaj Gaya, Sagara, all these people won over the entire, all the 7 islands. But they were not satisfied. They were very ambitious. The fire of ambition. So man can be happy only when he is satisfied with what he has. So these rules and regulations, I am somebody's son-in-law, I have to follow the rules. If I am superior, I have to follow the rules. If I am inferior, I have to follow the rules. And if I am teaching people, I have to follow the rules. I may be a teacher, but I have to follow the rules. I cannot boss over my students. I can teach them duty. Krishna finally says, a person who acts in this material world as he is duty bound, he has no karma. Even if he kills somebody. Right? That is also there. Even if he kills somebody, he has no karma. Why? Because he is acting as he ought to act as his duty. So when we are preaching, if you are not preaching as duty bound to the spiritual master, when you preach, credit goes to whom? Spiritual master. Why? My interest. This is my interest, payment of my monthly interest, daily interest. I do some service for the spiritual master, credit goes to whom? For the society in Krishna consciousness, to develop Krishna consciousness, credit goes to whom? Goes to the spiritual master. Because by his blessing, your faith in Krishna is increasing. And who is going to pay that debt? Until we finish paying the debt, we cannot go out of this material world. Something is keeping you in this material world. Etiquettes not followed keeps you in this material world. Etiquettes not followed keeps your faith in a tamasic level, rajasic level, or in the lower forms of sattvic level. You need to grow. Why happiness? I want happiness. What? Asma, spiritual happiness. Dependence on the Atma for happiness. Right? So as again Gita says, Sukham Atyantikam. What is pleasure in this material world? What is Sukha in this material world? What is the state of happiness? Material people think that a day comes when I don't have to respect anybody. A day comes when I'm not answerable to anybody. That day I'm called free. That doesn't happen. That's what material people consider. Well, that is not happiness. Happiness according to Krishna is different, right? Sukham atyantikam yattad buddhigrahyam atindriyam veti yatrana chaivayam stitas chalati tattvataha. The state. So when one relishes, this is characterized by one's ability to see the self by the pure mind and to relish and rejoice in the self. In that joy state, one is situated in boundless transcendental happiness and enjoys himself through transcendental senses. This is pleasure. This is spiritual pleasure. That is Brahman. This is actually Atmanirbhar, depend on the Atma. But the people use these words for material satisfaction. We are dependent upon our senses. We are dependent upon our mind. We are dependent upon satisfaction of my intellectual inquisitiveness. I am depending upon satisfaction of my different levels of ego. Are you depending on the Atma, happiness of Atma? Then you are spiritualist. So to reach that position, material etiquettes, vyavaharic etiquette becomes very important. Like we took the example of teaching, say preaching. We all are engaged in preaching. What is the etiquette to follow? Somebody goes to somebody's house to preach. He doesn't see an asan to sit. He doesn't see a glass of water. He doesn't see people to hear. Why did you call me? Walk out. He's not going to go up, he's going to go down. So a person preaching to material people, so many people are listening to me. I don't know what magic is happening. Everybody is touching my feet. Everybody is considering I am some great person. What is happening? Then he start enjoying that. Etiquette offered to him, enjoying that. He is offering the etiquette because he knows I ought to respect a devotee in saffron. I am in color dress. I am a grihastha. He is in saffron dress. He has already entered fire. I respect him. So he is doing because of that. And the man who is wearing the fire dress, he is singing differently. So finally what will happen? You preach to people. People whom you preach will go back to Godhead. We will remain here. No. You can't go back to Godhead. After I go only you can go. I brought you to Krishna consciousness. I taught you Krishna consciousness. So the Prabhu is going up, rising from the body and going up. No, get down. I had to go. No, he will go up. He will say, Prabhu, thank you very much. Thank you very much for teaching me what I should not do. I see the mistake of the Prabhu. He has learned what all should not be done. And he is going back to Godhead. Anyway, Prabhu, you taught me so much. You are my guru. He goes back. And now Prabhu is sitting. And the Prabhu says, at least I am guru. This is the depth of our self-interest. Self-interest of the mind, self-interest of the ego. If I need to give up this interest, I have to show the etiquettes. I have to respect the superiors. And the superiors who help you in spiritual life, you have to serve them. And that superior who is taking you back to Godhead, you have to do Atmanivedanam. Otherwise we cannot. These are set principles. This is the software is already set. You can't change the software. Spiritual software is already set. Sattvaguna, Rajoguna, Tamoguna. You have to go by the software only. And some other company has to come, some other software. That won't happen because there's only one God. So many people's questions, why this, why that? Sometimes we cannot. We need to. We have to do that. Because they are all building blocks of our spiritual foundation. So people who follow etiquette, they fly in spiritual life. Their faith is very deep. Otherwise our faith remains shallow. Faith in Shastra, faith in Guru, faith in the Supreme Lord, faith in the spiritual existence and virakti in the material world. This is what we need finally, because you can't go out of this material world unless virakti comes. And virakti can come only when your faith is strong. So if you want to cultivate faith, then all these vyavaharic things what we do become important. But ultimately, of course, remembering the Supreme Lord. If you are already remembering Supreme Lord, because you are remembering the Supreme Lord, you didn't do some etiquette, no problem. Because you are already in the Supreme Lord's consciousness. Like Shiva, he was in Brahman. A person who is in Brahman, he has no duty. No duty. Father, mother, like we say, Sarva Dhanman Parityaja, and the mother comes and says, you are not my father, you are not my mother. No, you are my father, your mother, until I go back to Krishna. And I respect you. And you respect me to be here. I respect you being there. But respect cannot be given up. Respect has to be there. That obligatory etiquette we have to follow. Many people help us in spiritual life. We forget. Paramatma doesn't forget. So if you are just somehow forgotten, but you are just Krishna conscious, it doesn't matter. But if you are not Krishna conscious to that level, you are not always thinking of the Supreme Lord, you are seeing Seeing also, knowledge. Sattvic knowledge, rajasic knowledge, tamasic knowledge. You are understanding that that same Brahman is existing in everybody. And you are seeing that one Brahman divided in these different people, but ultimately it's all one. That view is a Brahmanic, it's a pure Brahman, sattvic view. That view where you see different living entities in different bodies and you differentiate, that is rajasic. So if you are in the sattvic state of Brahman, where you are seeing only Brahman, then you become little free from the material etiquette. Because you are only seeing Brahman. Pandita Samadarshana already. You went beyond that. But you cannot fake it. Why didn't you respect me? Prabhu, I was in Brahman. Why didn't you answer the mail? Prabhu, I am in Brahman. Everything is same. I get a message, I have to reply. I get a question, I have to answer. So these etiquettes we cannot. So sometimes brahmacharis, we sometimes think we are transcendental. Transcendental. Not transcendental. So until you are really transcendental, you have to follow etiquettes. I can take anybody's shirt and wear, I can take anybody's shoes and wear, everything belongs to Krishna. Doesn't work. What is yours, use. Ishwapana says, what is yours, you use. Don't touch others. That also you have to follow. So this material world is a very dynamic place. There are so many dynamic things we need to learn at one shot. Sometimes people may get scared. Better I don't enter because there are so many things to follow. But these are all easy if one is humble, simple, meek, inquisitive, not challenging. Not proud. It becomes easy. Any questions, comments?
Hare Krishna Prabhu. Prabhu, you spoke about rules and regulations. We have to follow the rules and regulations. I know very well that organizations have set some rules and regulations and are to be followed by me. But sometimes due to some discretion or might be due to illusion, I start building rules and regulations for myself, thinking that is true. For an example, if I'm not able to complete my chanting, in the morning hours. So I plan, okay, let me miss some part of other part of the sadhana and try to manage my chanting. So this is the rule, regulation set by me for myself. So why does it happen so? Like, even though I know that rules and regulations are very important set by organization.
Prabhupada has given answer already. He said, if you are not able to finish your rounds, if you are not able to finish your reading quota of the day, eat less, sleep less. He did not say you cannot attend Guru Puja and then finish your chanting. He has not said that. It's already there. Set rules. So we have to reduce our personal conveniences, personal comforts to finish our spiritual duties. You cannot offset spiritual duties. No, I couldn't read because I had to chant. I couldn't chant because I had to read. I couldn't do this because of that. No. You sleep less. You eat less. You spend less time talking and wasting time. In that, we have to find time to finish our spiritual duties, sadhana. Not the other way around. So if you are setting your own standard, then you belong to the same question what Arjuna is asking. What happens to people who set their own standards? No. You cannot set your own standards. Yes, you may be in a position later on in life where you can fix your standards. You can be self-regulated. But in the Vaidhi Bhakti, there is no question of self-regulation. It is always regulated from outside. External regulation is there. And if you cannot follow external regulations, you will never come to a state where you can be a self-regulated person. Rishabhadeva says, you have to give up the attachment to the process of spiritual life itself. Well, to understand that, we need to discuss a lot. So point is, we need to be regulated. But there is a state later on. So we are not in that state. We do not know when we will reach that state. So safest is to always follow regulations. So much so that Krishna says even self-realized people follow regulations to set standards. Now, I'm a devotee of 15 years, 20 years. I don't have to follow. Wrong. Why? Because you are duty bound to your spiritual master to show others how important following is. So you are bound by that principle. You may not need, if I don't attend one or two mangalatis, I'm not going to fall down. Okay, but you have to attend because there are 1,000 people waiting to see whether you are attending or not. They are getting inspiration because you are attending. So then that becomes your duty to do it for the sake of others. And that is your payment back to spiritual master. So if you take our life, everything in as terms of this vyavahara, this transaction, then I'm free. I'm not worried about my happiness. I have finished my duty. Today's duty over, tomorrow's duty. All duties I'm finishing. He is happy. That's the state for us now. Yes. Etiquette, how is etiquette related to faith? Faith is related to the three modes of material nature, and etiquettes and interactions in the material world are in different levels of gunas, and the sattvic etiquette you follow, your faith increases. They are directly proportional. So, faith is connected to the modes, evolved by following different modes. So when you are following sattvic mode, in sattvic mode there is nothing like not following etiquette. If you are a sattvic person, dharmical person, then you follow all etiquettes, you know. And that gives you more. You follow dharmic. Why dharma should be followed? Krishna says in 10th canto, it increases your spiritual faith. That is why dharma has to be followed. That faith, rules and regulations in sattvic platform has to be followed. It's for my good. Every time we get the rules, why should I follow that Prabhu? Okay, to satisfy the Prabhu, let us do. Wrong. Then that becomes rajasic. You are following rules and regulations to satisfy somebody. I am following, it is rule to follow. I am following for the sake of following. Finish. That is a whole chapter of different modes, sacrifices in different modes, charity in different modes, following in different modes, knowledge in different modes. You can choose which mode you want. But Brahmanical, that is what Prabhupada said, this organization is to create Brahmanas. Which means for people who can follow all the sattvic etiquettes. Why? Because that is important as a launching pad for you to go to Krishna. There is no question of tamasic to go directly to Krishna, not possible. So then vyavaharas, etiquettes, social interactions are important. And Krishna says, sukha, dukkha, all these things are coming because of social interactions. So if you are having a sattvic interaction, then naturally you will have sattvic qualities of happiness, satisfaction, peacefulness. These are all something happening spoon by spoon. You don't measure it on a daily basis like going and taking measure of your body. Not possible. How much faith I have from 20 kilos faith? No. When your conviction in Krishna and nothing else is more and most interested, you know that you are growing. Self-assessment. You don't need a board of examination. Self-assessment. You can make your own questions, you can answer your own questions, you can put your own marks. And you know. Because spiritual life is not a cheating process. It's a very open, transparent process.